Hey everyone, it's Hiro here. Today, we are going back to the basics. Something really important for Medaka keepers, how to tell males and females apart. I've talked before about how to breed Medaka and other related topics, but never realized. I never really made a proper video just explaining the most basic part, how to sex them correctly. So, in this video, I wanna walk you through it clearly and carefully, especially for those of you who are just getting started with Medaka. After all, one of the most exciting parts of Medaka keeping is breeding, right? And just so you know, here in Japan, we developed all kinds of unique Medaka body types through selective breeding. So in this video, we'll go over both a standard body type and a special type called a Hikari body type. I really hope this helps you get a good understanding of how to tell males and females apart. On this channel, I, Hiro, a Medaka lover and aquarist from Japan, share all kinds of info about Japanese fish and aquariums. If you are into Medaka or Japanese aquatics, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss anything. Also, just a quick note, I'm still learning English, so I might make a few mistakes along the way. But I've added subtitles to help, so feel free to turn them on if you need them. Alright, let's get started. Let's begin by using the standard body type as our example. Here is a male Medaka. Males typically have three main features: a split or notch in the dorsal fin, a large rectangular anal fin, and a slimmer, more streamlined body compared to females. The earliest clue for most people is the notch in the dorsal fin. It's a pretty reliable marker. Now, here is a female Medaka. Females also have three key features: no notch in the dorsal fin, an anal fin that narrows toward the rear of the body, and a rounder, fuller body compared to males. Just like with the males, the dorsal fin is usually the earliest place to start. If there is no notch, it's likely a female. From above, you might notice that the body shape looks more rounded in females and more slender in males. But keep in mind that this can vary depending on their health and how well they've been fed. So once again, fins are your most reliable indicator when trying to tell them apart. And as you gain experience, you'll find you can often tell them different from above just by looking at the size and shape of the fins, especially the anal fin. So that's the basic way to tell male and female Medaka apart. Not too hard, right? And by the way, once the Medaka grow to about 2 cm in size, you can usually tell their sex. Some fish will even start laying eggs at the size. But generally speaking, they start breeding around 3 months of age. Here in Japan, we have many top-level Medaka breeders. One famous breeder called Jorakuan, based in Okayama Prefecture, is known for producing 6 generations of Medaka in single year. That's super fast, especially considering that in Japan's outdoor environment, with 4 distinct seasons, it's normal to get only 2 or 3 generations per year. They use greenhouse systems and carefully controlled environments to double the speed of their breeding programs. Personally, I really love their Medaka and have bought them many times. If I get chance, I'd love to visit Jorakuan and film a video there. Next, let's take a look at something a bit more challenging, the Hikari body type. To put it simply, Hikari Medaka have a flipped body structure. The lower half of their body is reversed along the spine, which makes the dorsal fin look like the anal fin. Not only that, the whole body shape changes. The usual trapezoid shape of the tail fin becomes more diamond-shaped, which also shows that reversal. So, as you might guess, the dorsal fin notch, our tracing marker for males, doesn't work here. That's right, you can rely on it many more. Instead, the shape and size of the anal fin becomes your main clue. In Hikari type males, the anal and dorsal fins are large and rectangular, which makes them look very prominent. In contrast, females have fins that get narrower toward the back, and their dorsal and tail fins look much slimmer. Here is a little fun fact. Sometimes in Hikari types, you might come across a Medaka with just the very tips of the dorsal fin split. This is called a samurai trait, because it looks like the tips of samurai sword. But don't confuse it with the standard dorsal fin notch we talked about earlier. The samurai split can appear in both males and females, so it's not a reliable way to tell sex. If you're interested in Hikari body types, by the way, I've uploaded another video that explains them in more details. So go check them out if you haven't seen it yet. Alright, so now you've learned the basics, but let me give you a few important tips. The examples I showed today all have a pretty clear feature that makes sexing easy. But in real life, it's not always that simple. Sometimes male dorsal fins have only a very shallow notch, or anal fins might be small, making them look like females. And some females may even have a slight notch or unusually large fins. These cases aren't super common, but they do exist. So be aware of that. Also, with all the newer fin types out there, like wide fins and long fins, it's getting harder even for professionals to be 100% sure. So what should we do when it's too hard to tell? You breed them. If you pair up a male and a female, and they're both healthy and compatible, they're usually showing mating behavior. So the best way to confirm sex is to put them together and observe. If nothing happens, no breeding, no eggs, it might be because you accidentally paired two males or two females. In that case, just try swapping one of the fish and see that happens. Of course, other factors like illness or poor compatibility can also affect breeding, so this method isn't perfect, but it's still a great way to double check. So, what do you think? Today, we went over how to tell male and female Medaka apart, both in the standard body type and in the Hikari type. I hope this helped you feel more confident about identifying them. If you are new to this, feel free to rewatch the video as many times as you need. It gets easier with practice. If you found the video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions or thoughts, drop a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. And of course, if you want to cheer me on, your kind comments really motivate me to keep making these videos. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.